life first appeared on Earth sometime between 3.5 and 4 billion years ago. Was this the natural outcome of the laws of chemistry operating on a primordial organic soup? Or is the origin of life evidence of God's action within his creation? And do we really have to choose? The Earth formed from cosmic dust, or stardust, about 4.6 billion years ago, in a rotating disk around our young sun. Initially, our home planet was very hot, too hot for any life to exist on its surface. Over the next millions of years, it cooled down and would have become cool enough to be habitable if it had not been for explosive encounter with a Mars-sized object, which led to the evaporation of much of the Earth's surface, as well as the formation of the moon. After a second cool down, the Earth became hospitable to water and carbon-based life just over 4 billion years ago. We don't know exactly how long it took for our planet to go from being hospitable to life to hosting life. But 500 million years later, or 3.5 billion years ago, the Earth was teeming with living cells. Where did this life come from? From astronomy and geology, we have scientific evidence that water and small organic molecules, that is, carbon-containing molecules, were readily available on the young Earth. And experiments have shown that under the right conditions, these small organic molecules can naturally self-organize into larger ones, like amino acids and RNA and DNA bases. To go from amino acids and DNA and RNA bases to life, these molecular building blocks must then combine to form the macromolecules all forms of life today rely on. These are things like proteins and DNA and RNA chains, which in turn must organize themselves to form a working cell. At first sight, this chain of events may seem impossible to enact through natural causes. How could random reactions between molecules result in something as complicated as a cell? But the laws of chemistry are not random, and there are recent experiments that show that such complex chemical self-organization may be possible. Nevertheless, it is still important to note that no one has yet figured out how nature can spontaneously proceed all the way from cell building blocks to working cells. So while there are several hypotheses, the origin of life is not at present scientifically explained. This has led some to suppose that the origin of life must have been miraculous, the direct creation of God. This would also seem to be supported by the biblical creation account of the first life on Earth. Now, it is true that only God can create in the precise sense of the term. What I mean is that only God can call things into existence out of nothing. We hold, consistent with, though not proven by, the Big Bang theory, that God created the whole cosmos in this meaning of the term. But within his created reality, scientific inquiry can reveal the secondary or instrumental causes through which God, as the primary cause, has acted to develop his creation. With this interpretive lens, we can look again at the biblical account of the creation of living things, and note that the first life, vegetation, appears as God draws it out of the earth with his speech. That is, life does not appear out of nothing in Genesis, but rather appears as God develops or transforms his creation. If a convincing scientific theory of the origins of life was to emerge, this would not remove God as the creator of all living things, but would rather reveal the precise secondary causes he used to transform non-living matter into living beings. Such an interpretation would continue a long-standing tradition within the Catholic Church to take into account scientific knowledge when reading Genesis. St. Thomas Aquinas himself frequently incorporated existing natural knowledge of the earth into his readings of biblical texts. A second argument for a miraculous beginning to life on earth holds that it is philosophically impossible for inanimate things to give rise to living beings. But this is not the philosophical opinion of St. Thomas Aquinas, who does think that under some special circumstances, certain kinds of lower animals can emerge from inanimate matter. In fact, the philosophical and theological tradition of St. Thomas Aquinas offers some reasons to think that the origin of life was a natural process. Aquinas held that God endowed the cosmos with real causal powers, and that God acts for the most part through these secondary causes. Scientifically, we know that God formed the earth through the secondary causality of dust coagulation, and that he produced animals through the secondary causality of species evolving under natural selection. It would seem fitting for the story of our origins if the link between these two developments, the emergence of life, also occurred through natural causes. By contemplating the possibility of such a natural transformation from inanimate objects to animate organisms, using the tendency of molecules to organize themselves into interesting structures under the laws of chemistry, we are not limiting God's role in creation. God is always the primary cause and the giver of existence to all. Rather, we are celebrating what kind of creator he has revealed himself to be, and the amazing ways that creation itself participates in the Lord's design of his cosmos. For readings, podcasts, and more videos like this, go to Aquinas101.com. While you're there, be sure to sign up for one of our free video courses on Aquinas. And don't forget to like and share with your friends, because it matters what you think.